26 Speed Week contenders down the Bentley Continental GT Speed. Never thought I'd see a car that big sliding around. Bug, the BRX Hunter, pretty much the most fun that you can have on four wheels, and the Caterham 170R, because as we all know, there was quite a big animated conversation around this car, mainly around the fact that it was a bit overcomplicated, especially in the corners on track. It feels like the hybridism on the front axle was communicating back there. But one thing you cannot debate is just how faith-healingly fast this thing is on the road. The traction, the accessibility, on the road, on the track, wherever you want to put it. Now, yes, this has the new double accessory on the road, but potentially lost a little bit of character. The overall experience is actually that different to the old GT3. So, 9,000 RPM, still got the PDK gearbox keying through the gears, although in fairness, I think I'll probably have one of these with a manual gearbox. It still feels like the best built car here. What this is a car that gives you no reasons not to buy one. Not the rear arm, but styling to one side for a minute and talk about the question that still persists over this car's price. You can actually listen to the question of this car, traction, the traction you generate, the bumps of the engine, the way you can tailor the drivetrain and the chassis in myriad ways. It's a mile road trip without blinking, and then sit sideways all day, perhaps, but this extremely sympathetic resto mod is just fantastic. Drive. It's been upgraded to be better than new. It costs a mere £45,000, but for something that's going to make you smile and laugh every single day that you own it, that's a bit of a bargain. It might even work too. I actually drove this thing here this morning. I had a 50-mile drive, and genuinely, when everything goes digital and electric, this is a